My name is Leticia, and I am very honored to be your mentor today. 2 years ago, I was a contestant. I had my high school degree very young. I was 15. And when it was time to choose what I would do next, what I would study, I didn't know. I was completely lost because everything I was interested to was artistic things. But in my country, it's very hard to make a living doing art. So I just couldn't tell to my parents, hey, I want to be an artist. They just will look like, what are you saying? So I let my parents choose for me. And I went in the best university in my country. And at the end of those 3 years, I had to take an internship in a company to validate my diploma. And this is where I think I had my click. I wanted to do more. I had so imagination, I had creativity. I just wanted to use it to make a living. My personality was stronger, so I was able now to tell my parents, this is not what I want. So I was just trying to think about what I could do to start something. And at the same time, I was always on the internet and I was seeing those people on YouTube, on Instagram, creating things, creating content, inspiring people around them. And I was like, maybe I could also use my smartphone and my internet connection to do something. Why not? You are creative, you can do something and maybe see where it will bring you. And one day I saw a picture, it was an album, several pictures of women in Africa in ancient tribu, like very hot picture in black and white, and they were wearing a lot of very amazing hair. And I was so inspired when I saw those pictures. I wanted to experiment with my hair too, because I was already good with hair. I was braiding everyone around me, my sister, my friends, everyone. I started to do some experiments with my own braid, my own hair. And when I posted the first picture, everyone was just wow. The like, the comment, the share, it was very encouraging. So I continued. First, it was just for fun. One day I started to receive message from black women saying that what I was doing was helping them to love themselves a little bit more. And this is where I start to associate my activism to my art, because I knew it could have an impact. And then one day, someone at Elite come to me and talk to me about the contest. So I went in Paris for the final and I won. And it was one of the most beautiful days of my life. I was able to collaborate with a lot of amazing brand, and I was able to learn a lot of things about social media too. So now I will try to share with you the tips. The first tip I will say, if you have to choose a niche, you have to know what you are doing on social media. It's very important. It's important that people be able to associate your brand to something. Another thing I can say is that try to engage with your audience. It's very important. We are successful because all those people are rooting for us, and it's very important to give this love back sometime.
Do you have any tips on finding your niche when you don't really have one?
This is really hard for me to say to another person how to find his niche, because I think it's something really personal. But I think it's something we and only us are able to do, because we are the people that know ourselves the most. I'm happy we were able to share something. I think you actually in one of the best experience of your life. Even if it's digital, it's still one of the best experience ever, and you will be able to have a lot of beautiful opportunity after that. Stay consistent, and sometimes you will feel like you will feel bad, you will feel low. It's okay, it's part of the process. Just know that you're the best, you can do it, and you will be able to achieve everything you want in life. I wish you the best, and I was really happy to be here.